Imagine being stubbornly using your EdgeHD 9¼ head native focal length, and to fit larger targets, you apply the new mosaicking function in Cyril. So you first calibrate and then stack the individual panels. And then you add the panels to a new sequence in Cyril, after which you plate solve the entire stack and register all panels based on those plate solves. Then you get to stack or stitch them together, only to find out that it will just multiply the issues you have in your individual panels. It is in those moments that you wish you had mounted that reducer a long time ago. So in this video, I'll show how it took a hacksaw to mount it. Stick around till the end to see if I could improve on the image I just showed. Hey, hello. It is time for a simple, small video. Ever since I have this 9¼ EdgeHD, I never mounted the reducer because there's something in the way. My EAF. As you can see, the big nut over here is going to touch the EAF bracket. So, we'll have to cut it. I covered the telescope with a lid. Now we'll remove the EAF here outside because I think that is the most convenient. Let's not drop the screws in the grass, then I'll be screwed. The EAF. So and now we remove this plate. Of course, it's a different size. Why make it easy? Of course, it's a different size. Why make it easy? Which one is it? This one? No. Smaller. This one? I guess I can use a nice little gadget here. Never mind, I have this magnetic thing, but these screws are not magnetic. Is the magnet even working still? Yes, it is. Remember the orange plate and what happens if you don't mount this? Well, here we have the bracket and we need to remove a bit. So let's go to the shed and see if I manage this. So this is the plate. I need to cut a little bit off. I'm curious what would be the best approach here. I could mount it like this and just cut the top half off. I think that is the best bet of success here. Yep. Wish me luck.
I'm not that heroic with tools. Something like this, and the iron hacksaw. So let's make it a bit smaller. I guess I need to sand it a bit as well, otherwise I'll keep cutting myself. What do I sand it with? Let's just time to mount it to the telescope again. Let's not forget the plate. There's a bit of an oil kind of substance, and then slowly, due to gravity, the thing drops out. So let's see. Needs to be like this. Let's make sure that the plate is going in straight and not that I tighten one screw further than the other one. It's going to be quite some challenge, I think, to get the initial focus correct. So I guess we'll be using video mode on a distant rooftop or something like that to get it just about right. Let's get the EAF again and mount that, or shall we? Let's first try the reducer again, so we can see if we cut far enough. Here we have the reducer again. First, we need to remove this one. There we go. Perfect. And this end can come off, where I then mount this part again, I believe. And the rest of the assembly is attached there again. Let's get the EAF. This attaches here again. Let's mount the rest. First of all, I mount the part that goes into the OEG. I'm just guessing that this is going to be the correct back focus distance. I have to look up another video of myself to see what the correct back focus would be, how I would achieve that. There we have it. A camera with reducer. Oh, you can't even see the camera. There it is. Let's connect up the peripherals. See, number one is the camera power. It can still reach it. Nice. What is this? Oh yeah, the EAF lead. Then we have the USB for the guide camera. We have the power for the dew heater of the camera. The main power for the ASI Air, which I will route through here. And the USB lead for the camera. A USB cable for the mount, and I will tuck away this cable for the temperature sensor. I had that stuck here, like so. Cool. Let's clean up a bit, turn the thing on and see if we can get focus.